All right, ladies and gentlemen. Your first title fight of the evening right here at the World Class Fight League features three-minute rounds in the 145-pound WCFL division. This bout is brought to you by Redline Design, NFE, and Detour Protein Bars. Your referee in charge of this bout is Mr. Ross Kellen.
Did Matos pick this song to come out to?
And now, introducing first, fighting
yes,
out of the blue
did.
Corner. We have a mixed martial artist with an amateur record of one win and one loss. He stands at 5'6" tall and weighed in at 145 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, from Team SPMF, make some noise for Case Wagner.
Wagner looks focused. Look at those eyes.
Case had his eyes on that belt tonight, that
and
is for
introducing
sure.
Introducing his opponent, standing across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. This mixed martial artist has an amateur record of 5 wins and 1 loss. He stands at 5'7" tall and weighed in at 145 pounds. He trains with Gracie Tampa South. Put your hands together and welcome Danny Matos.
Matos has been waiting for this title shot for like 6 months. The last time his opponent pulled out, and this time his opponent pulled out, but he had a backup this time.
Matos is your typical amateur MMA fighter looking for the big break. Scrapping up change to pay for training, coming in every single day, working his butt off. This is a really big fight for him. This means a lot for him in his personal life. I'm very excited to watch this take place.
He looked like he had a tough cut yesterday, too. He looked really hungry. He was holding on to that granola bar.
This is going to be awesome.
Oh,
Case's
nice.
Game.
Matos really working on the stand-up with Coach Eric Parker.
And yeah, Matos comes from a predominantly jiu-jitsu school.
Went for that spin back.
But he's definitely been working on a stand-up for sure.
Yeah, he trains with Matt Arroyo, former Ultimate Fighter veteran. Nice combinations by Matos.
Staying very relaxed and very calm.
Nice sidekick.
Throwing spinning techniques. Definitely showing a repertoire of his skill.
Very calm, too. He's picking his shots. Nice combination by Casey.
Nice lead hook over top.
Oh, wow. Just Casey stepped to the side just to avoid that. Nice combination by Matos.
Does Matos have the knockout power? I'm not exactly sure, but he's doing a great job of landing some clean shots.
His last fight, he landed a nasty spin back fist that changed the whole momentum of that fight. Oh, he got caught with the left hook on that.
He ate a very big hand right there. Let's see how he recovers.
Casey Wagner's style reminds me a lot of like a Dan Henderson. Just in your face.
Yes, he is.
Whoa, head kick by Matos. Got
nice
the clinch
big
working.
Head kick.
Knees to the body there. Casey needs to get those underhooks and turn them. There he goes.
Reversed him on the cage.
Still in trouble here.
A lot of the game could be won or lost in the clinch, so we're going to see who's going to take advantage of their skill level here.
Matos staying busy with those knees to the thigh, to the stomach. Casey's got some big legs, though. Uh-oh, he's going for
a
guillotine.
Stuck his neck out right there.
He's going for that guillotine. Oh, he got out.
People don't realize how tiring this inside clinch game could be, especially when you're up against the cage. Makes your upper body and your forearms very, very exhausted.
And if you're not used to being in this position, you're gassed out quick.
Absolutely.
This fight's going back and forth. I haven't
Yeah, we're
even.
Seeing a lot of transitions on putting their backs up against the cage.
Casey going for the takedown. He got it.
He got a big takedown with the crowd cheering his name.
Let's see Matos' guard here. He comes from a legit school, Gracie Tampa South.
Yeah, it looks Matos like has some post. Awesome jiu-jitsu training. He's sunning the Kimura right now because Casey's got his hand on the mat. With only 30 seconds left in the match,
sweep.
You really got to be
tight
careful.
Hips from a wrestler. But he got back up using it.
What
Watches
a great first round.
Oh, he's got the guillotine
We've
with
got
10 seconds.
Seconds left. Can he finish it? Can he drive his hips enough? He's got the arm in. It's going to be very difficult to finish this
position.
Very
close finish. Oh, the round ends.
Very
what
nice
What an exciting
job.
Finish. Matos, a close round, but I give it to Matos. Squeeze out that first round.
Matos showing some resilience at the end there, really trying to finish.
Both guys in shape. Neither one of them look tired.
Yeah, coming to the second round, I think we're going to see him just as fresh.
World Class Fight League sponsors. We got Bernie Gonzalez and Penthouse in here. After parties at the Penthouse tonight.
Absolutely. We got a Wing House sponsor. We've got Alibi Whiskey.
We'd also like to invite everybody to check out Karen, our ring card girl, on the field as she cheers for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers this season.
You heard that. Karen's still an active Buccaneers cheerleader. Here we go, round two. Matos looks a little more livelier this round.
Here we go, round two.
Casey going right for the takedown.
Big left hook from the right from the bat from Danny Matos.
Nice. Oh, nice head kick
again. Nice, beautiful head kick.
Throwing
the
thrust. And Danny gets a takedown.
Takes him down, lands in side control. Really can't ask for more than that in a transition.
Big
Casey
mistake.
Wagner holding the head, but it's really a mistake
going
to try to hold the head from side mount. It's a really good chance to get submitted or lose position from here.
Now he can't get his arm out because of the MMA glove. There he
Danny
goes.
Danny Matos easily pops his head out.
Look at that control. Pulling him to the cage. Pushing him to the cage. They could probably hit knees to the body here. Trying to transition to the back.
Definitely wants to try to improve his position, and pushing over the cage is going to allow him to do that. Staying nice and heavy, not really giving Casey any room to move.
Casey going to use the cage here. See if he pushes off here. Look at the wrestler hips. He got right back up using that hip. Guillotine, and he's going for a double leg. And gets, oh no, Matos.
Nice, beautiful right up on Danny Matos. Great
going for
sprung.
Anaconda.
He's got a choke in their head and arm. He's rolling. We call that the gator roll at Gracie Tampa. He's got the leg hooked.
He lost his arms though when he rolls. Casey on top. This is a competitive fight.
Well, going this is a great fight. Hunting for the triangle choke right now, and he jumps it. He's got the diamond position. He needs to get that arm across in order to finish.
Casey needs a posture. Oh, he got out. Nice up kicks by Matos. Casey kicking the legs. Looking
for
a big punch, it looks like.
We hear Gracie Tampa South's corner saying, forward, forward, get up and go. They want to push the pace.
Ah, back to the spin back fist.
Seen a couple of those from Matos.
Is that
tonight.
A technique they work a lot at Gracie Tampa South?
Under coach Eric Parker, absolutely. He loves spinning techniques. He comes from a kickboxing background.
Casey's got a guillotine.
But Danny Matos has got to watch his neck.
Oh, he's got position off of using a sweep him. This is a competitive fight.
Here we go, 10 seconds left.
Who finishes strong here? I got him one round apiece now.
I agree. I'm right there with you.
Try to finish with a Kimura. What a round.
Let's see what number three brings.
Action packed. Casey Wagner's game.
Tough guy for sure.
Remember, only three rounds here, so last and final fight. I mean, round right here. Whoever wins this round is going to win this belt.
Danny Matos very lucky to have a very experienced camp in his corner. A former Ultimate Fighter, Gracie Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. Listen to what your coaches say and you should be okay.
Casey's got Loaded Some Cave from Ultimate Fighter also.
Got some really big names here in the building tonight.
Yeah, WCFL brings all the celebrity, local celebrities out for their action-packed fights. Dwayne Spires and Ralph Garcia, bring it.
Best matchmaker in the area.
And then we had Art of Grappling today. We had 300 kids in here competing. All the kids came here. They're all here supporting.
Huge
local
tournament
gyms
today.
Long day.
Here we go. This is it right now.
Both
who
guys
wants
going
it
for the takedown, look like.
Mato secures it with a nice side control position.
Casey making a big mistake holding on to that head, though. Big no-no.
You got to know when to let it go. You got to know when to let it go and just work from the best possible situation that you can be in from that moment.
There he goes. Matos with side control. He was here in first round and pretty much dominated it the whole round.
Doing some nice shoulder pressure. Really trying to kick his opponent, not rushing too much.
See how bad Casey wants this. Casey needs to get off his back now. Amateur fights are only 3-minute rounds, so you don't have that much time to work. Casey trying to muscle out, just wearing himself out.
Last thing you want to do is force something.
Stepping over the head, looking for that armbar.
Is he tight enough is going to be the question, especially with those shin guards.
No, transition to north-south. Now he's in front. Casey gets right up. See if Casey doesn't sit out here. Mato's going for the back. Got a harness. Uh-oh, digging for that choke.
There he is, trying to sink it in right now.
Oh, Casey defends well, wow.
Very nice hip switch by Denny Mato's.
He's got to watch here. He needs to get up, he's losing this round right now. Oh, he gets up. He needs to get busy here, though.
Absolutely. Need to work on sweeping, getting up, and passing, and scoring some more points.
Guillotine again. It's tight. That looks tight.
Well, that's...
Mato's defending, though. He's got his arm in. He needs to get his elbow down. Mato's listening to his corner.
Not that far.
His head right out. What a fight.
Beautiful.
This is going to be a close fight to call. I wouldn't want to be a judge on this one. Mato's needs to get busy with that ground and pound. Casey's trying to get back up.
Until they're both getting tired. Here we go. 10 seconds. Let's go, guys.
What an exciting title fight for the 145 WCFL title.
Beautiful way to kick it off.
What a fight. Close fight. I think Mato's pulled it out, though. Definitely, Casey's stock went up after this fight today. Even if he loses, he proved he can hang with the big boys.
Absolutely, I was definitely impressed.
Gentlemen, put your hands together for both of these fighters. That was a great 145-pound title fight. After three rounds of fighting, we go to the official MMA Solutions scorecard to determine your WCFL champion. Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, your champion by way of unanimous decision is Denny Mato! Danny Matos, Gracie Tampa South. Danny, congratulations. We've got Wing House presenting you with the championship shirt right here. You've got your belt. 145-pound WCFL champion. Congrats. How are you feeling right now, Danny?
Hold on, I gotta get this belt over my shoulder. It's too big. So, I'm feeling really great right now. Very hungry, actually. But I would like to thank my coaches, Coach Adam Cantor for my wrestling, Professor Arroyo for my Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Couldn't have evolved far without him training me. Coach Eric Parker for my Muay Thai. And not to mention his great seminars with intensity, which got me into the cortex. You want to be a great fighter for this future? You need to start thinking with your cortex, not emotionally. That's what he teaches. Coach Jeff Bailey for giving me my conditioning and everything I go through. My little nephew who's watching me today. Without him, I'm nothing. For my family, my friend, for the WCFL for giving me this chance to compete for this title. It was great. I enjoyed this so much. I trained hard and see how it works. Hard training and hard work beats natural talent any day. For anybody that's a rock bottom, use me as an example. I came with nothing and now I'm something.
You are something. You are the 145-pound WCFL champion, sir.
Now, for a sponsor of WCFL, Alibi Whiskey, and get a bottle and come party.
Speaking of Alibi Whiskey, Bill from Alibi is giving every title fight contender right now a bottle of whiskey before you guys go home, winners and losers, because you know, even if you lost a fight, you need an Alibi. That's your drink? Oh, he doesn't drink. I'm sure you guys can split it up. So congrats again. And we look forward to having you come back to defend that belt. Ladies and gentlemen, Danny Matos, the 145-pound WCFL champion right here. Hey, John. John, what'd you think about this fight right here?
I think he's very talented, and when he's ready to go pro, I'd like him to talk to us. We'll give him his shot when he turns pro.
Sounds good right here, ladies and gentlemen. Danny Matos has the invitation from Prisco for the XFC when he's ready to turn pro. It's on.